Today's video is made possible by the fittings of AkuraMeister. Use the link in the description to visit their website. Hello and welcome to today's video, that is the second part of the repair of this cello. If you haven't seen the previous one, the link is here. In the previous video I was working on the top, it is ready now, and in today's video I'm going to concentrate on the ribs. There are a lot of cracks that I have to glue and reinforce again. And I'm going to change the pegs, the mechanical ones are going off, and I'm going to put new ones. A lot to do, so let me clean the instrument to start with. The inner side is really very dirty, especially these ribs where I want to work. Let me get the vacuum cleaner. Now I'm going to remove all these reinforcements because they are very chunky and most of them are already loose, and I want to put new ones on a different way. The inner part of the rib is finally clean. There was also a thick layer of glue under some of the old reinforcements. As you may have seen, also some went very easily off, so they didn't do so much. Now I'm going to glue the crack. I was planning to glue several in one time, but I'm not going to do because this one is really big. I'm going to use white glue because that will give me more time to put everything correct in place. And this is a kind of crack that I don't want to open ever again. So the white glue will keep it very nice on place. Making your own violin, viola or cello, takes a lot of time and effort, as you know. And that's why, as soon as the instrument is almost ready, I like to treat myself, and the instrument of course, with a nice set of fittings. For this instrument that I made in the Making a Violin series, I used the fittings made by AkuraMeister, and I went for a heel model pegs and tailpiece made in ebony, but they have many more. Their product range includes fittings for violin, viola and cello. Mainly they have two series, the Ultimo and Preciso. They use boxwood, ebony, rosewood, snakewood and tintool, and make the fittings in various models. As you have seen in another video, I have also used the tintool fittings, and these also look beautiful. For more information and to place an order, visit their website, the link is in the description. As soon as the glue was dry, I removed the clamps and glued the rest of the cracks. All the cracks are glued, that means that I can go ahead and reinforce them. And as you have seen in other videos, I am going to use this 0.5 millimeter thick plywood that can bend very well, and is very strong. The last patches are glued and dry. That means that I can remove the clamps for the last time. And now I could glue the top on place, and I will, but before that, as in the next video, I'm going to remove the back to work on the soundpost crack. I want to at least open the part that is over the notch, because that is very hard to open, and now I have access also from the inner side, that makes it easier. So I will open only a small part here, and I will remove the rest of the back in the next video. A part of the back is already open, so that will help, makes it easier. Let's see. Let me put you up high so you can see what I'm doing. I can't remove the back as easy as I was expecting. That's why I'm going to put some water on the inner side and leave it for a couple of hours. The back is loose, that means that I can go ahead and glue the top on place. The top is in place, I also removed the clamps already. Now I'm going to work on the pegs. As you see, I have only three of these special pegs. The fourth is missing. I have never had it. That's why I'm going to remove them, and I'm going to put new pegs that I just last week received from Akkurameister. Here is the box. I also have a beautiful tailpiece. We are going to see that in the last video where I'm going to mount the instrument. And of course, four pegs. 1, 2, 3, 4. I have worked in the past with the violin pegs, as you know, and these ones look as beautiful and as high quality, but we will see how they work. First of all, I have to remove the old ones by untightening the four screws. With the old pegs removed, I can start cleaning the holes. As you see, it can go a bit deeper. The pegs are in place. There is still a lot to do, as on the sides there are a lot of holes, but I will fix that in the last video where I'm going to mount the instrument. I have to say once again that I like the quality of the pegs a lot. The ebony is very good, it works very well with the scrapers. And of course the peg is made very well. And I don't say that because they are sponsoring my video, it is the other way around. They sponsor my video because I like their products a lot and I can recommend them also to you. So that means that we arrived at the end of today's video. In the next video I'm going to work on the back to repair the soundpost crack. Don't forget to subscribe. I have seen that less people are watching my videos the last couple of months and I think that you don't get the notifications, so don't forget to use the bell icon as well. Like the video and I will see you next time again. Bye bye!